In this Rhino tutorial, we'll learn how to model a chain like this for jewelry. We could 3D print. I actually 3D printed this one in bronze and it turned out well. You just have to be careful that there's enough spacing because on a few links they got stuck, but otherwise it works well. First of all, I would like to thank Jack Mayer. He's an amazing jewelry maker in the UK. Very good at Rhino, and he showed me quite a few of those jewelry tricks. This is his website. There's a lot of good resources on his website, so make sure to check it out. And he'll be publishing a book on Rhino 7. I had access to a lot of the book. It's really good material. So thanks, Jack. The render, I did it with Modo. So I just brought the Rhino file into Modo. But today I'll just focus on the modeling. So this is three type. One where I use Boolean here to cut off the top and bottom. One where I use a bend and just a regular one here. So we'll start with this one. Also, I wanted to show you that I started an Etsy page where I sell a few of the tutorials that I created with you, and I sell them at cost. So you see, I'm not making this to make money, at least for now. Maybe one day, but so basically I think I'm making a profit of $1 for the fee. And it's a good example because it shows you how much it costs to 3D print or cast something. So this is an example. I modeled this in Rhino, render in Modo, a SpaceX keychain 3D printed with it's called Jetturbine, with a 3D laser sintering machine using stainless steel and bronze. And then it's powder coated in black. So this is really top-notch material. And you see, so in nylon was also very good, $12 and in 18 US. And that, I don't know if it includes shipping, I have no idea. But anyway, I just wanted to show you, so a lot of them are here. This one is the same type of thing. This ring turned out very well. I was actually quite impressed. So this is 3D printed in wax, 16 micron wax. And then they cast it in pure sterling silver and buff it. And like I said, I was very surprised with how well it turned out. So yeah. And also I started a Weebly page to show some of my student work and mostly some of my work. So this one is a student, the rest is mine. And there's a few other students somewhere. This is a student, this is a student, this is a student, this is me. So all of this was done in Rhino Modo. And on the bottom, there's a bit of soft image, I think, in Maya. And it's called Simply 3D Design. And once again, if you're into jewelry, check out Jack's website. It's excellent. So let's get started. I'll be using Rhino 7, but you could be using Rhino 6, 4, or 5. And we'll start in the top view, and we'll use a torus. So torus, top view, 0 for the center. Hold shift to be straight, click. You could also define a diameter here if you wanted, and then shift click to define the second diameter. And here the rule of thumb is to have enough space for those two. I'm pressing Alt to copy. So we can actually shrink this one a bit. There is a distance that we need to know. It's the spacing between the start of this link and the start of this one. You can use dim with Alt so you don't snap. We've got 16 mil. Or we can use distance. So just keep this number in your head, 16.3. But now you might want to shape this differently because here it looks pretty simple. So we'll type bend, 0 from the center, shift. And we'll want to turn symmetric to yes. And you want to go higher so it passed the first circle. Voila. On the top, we can click on the green and go 45. And now we might have to remeasure this. So I'll go Alt. And you see, give it enough space. Dim once again, and let's see the difference now. I'm pressing Alt and Shift. Pretty much the same, 15.2 mil. We only need one link. The curve could be any shape. I just use a regular curve, 0. At the beginning, make sure the curve is straight, so I'm holding shift. And in the corner, you need an F point. The shape doesn't matter, and we can change it after. Okay, I could go shift again. And even here, shift. It's fine, as long as we have enough point here. Voila. And maybe we'll move this here, at least for now, because it's a small curve I did. Have a record history turn on, and then we use the command called array. Array means duplicate, many copy, array curve. Object to array, path to array. And in the past, Rhino, you would get a pop-up, but in 7, it's here. So you have to type that distance. It was 15.1, I think. And you see, we might have one duplicate, but otherwise, it's perfect. Right-click. And we could have changed, huh? Maybe 15, when you see it touch here, but here it's fine. So maybe 15 would have worked better, or 0.1, or 15.2. You just have to try. Now I can select the curve, grab a point, and because we had record history, you see we can change it and the link will update. We could do a boolean to top them, to cut them on the top and bottom. There's many variations that we can do, but that's basically it. Thank you.